It's pretty easy to get the 6.0 to about the 450 rear wheel horsepower and 800 wheel torque ballpark with just a couple basic bolt-on modifications. Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be talking about bolt-on modifications for the 6.0 Powerstroke. It's pretty easy to get the 6.0 to about the 450 rear wheel horsepower and 800 wheel torque ballpark with just a couple basic bolt-on modifications. Things start to get pretty expensive once you start looking to push past the 500 wheel horsepower range, so we're going to go ahead and cover all of the basic bolt-ons that can safely get you within the 400 to 450 wheel horsepower ballpark, as well as cover some of the considerations and engine power limits if you're looking to take things beyond the 500 wheel horsepower mark. We did do a video somewhat recently discussing reliability on the 6.0 Powerstroke, where we probably said somewhat not nice things about the overall reliability of this engine. And that becomes important once we start talking about performance modifications, because adding additional power and tuning the engine is something that will really open up the weak points of this engine. The whole topic of bulletproofing is something that we'll go into a lot more depth on in a following video, but I will go ahead and just say that before making any of these performance modifications, I recommend at least having an upgraded oil cooler, because the oil cooler is the one thing that leads to a lot of the problems on the 6.0 Powerstroke. So by upgrading that and fixing that, we can actually reduce a lot of the reliability issues and make it safe to mod and tune the 6.0. Before we jump into the bolt-on modifications, let's go ahead and talk about some engine power limits that you need to be aware of. The first limit that you're going to run into is with the factory injectors. The factory injectors are good for about 425 to 450 wheel horsepower. I'd recommend upgrading to 155cc injectors, which are good for up to about 500 wheel horsepower, especially if you have older injectors or if one of them starts to fail, just because if you're looking to push 450 wheel horsepower, that's going to be the absolute limit of the factory injectors, and so you're going to lose some reliability from the injectors there, but you might also run into some fueling related issues trying to push those right up to their power limit. With respect to the rest of the fueling system, if you have some larger injectors, you're good until about 500 wheel horsepower. At that point, that's when we recommend upgrading your lift pump. If you get a 140 GPH lift pump, that'll take you up to about 700 wheel horsepower. You will need larger than 155cc injectors to get there, but the rest of the fueling system is relatively stout and capable with larger injectors and with a lift pump added around the 500 wheel horsepower mark. The stock turbo is going to be the second limiting factor after the factory injectors. The stock turbo can handle about 475 wheel horsepower. You might be able to push that up to 500 if you want to kill it. But if you're looking to carry much past 450 to 475, that's when we recommend upgrading the turbocharger. The transmission, which tends to be the weak point on a lot of diesel engines, is actually pretty decent on the 6.0. It can handle over 500 wheel horsepower before you need to start looking at upgrades there. So fortunately, the transmission is pretty good and shouldn't need any upgrades until you get beyond the 500 wheel horsepower mark. Those are kind of the main engine limits to be aware of. Again, as I mentioned, once you start trying to push past 450 wheel horsepower is when things start to get expensive, because you're going to need upgraded injectors, you're going to want to consider adding a lift pump, you're going to need an upgraded turbocharger, and if you want to push too much beyond 500, you're also going to want to look at a couple transmission upgrades as well. We're going to go ahead and talk about all of the modifications that are going to get you to a somewhat reliable and safe 400 to 450 wheel horsepower 6.0 Powerstroke. So the first thing on our list is tuning. Tuning is hands down the best modification really for any diesel engine. This is where you're going to get the biggest power gains and the best bang for your buck. On the 6.0, the preferred tuning platform is SCT. You can use the SCT X4, but a lot of people prefer to run the Livewire TS Plus, which is going to be the better option of the two. It comes with some pretty good preloaded tunes, but a lot of tuners out there will also sell you the Livewire TS Plus with a couple custom canned tunes that are loaded onto it at no additional cost. But this is a great platform because it comes with preloaded tunes, so it's pretty easy to just plug and play it if you're just looking for some basic plug and play power gains, but it's also capable of custom tuning. And so it is a great platform that gives capabilities for those people that are just looking for a basic plug and play tuner to get some power gains and some fuel economy increases. But it also works and is the best platform for the people that are really looking to push these engines and get some serious custom tuning done on them. So the biggest thing here is you're going to get big power gains. The preloaded tunes on the SCT are going to go up to 120 horsepower and 250 torque. There's also a lot of good economy tunes that can help you see 2 to 4 mile per gallon fuel economy increases. Overall, tuning is great for power gains. It's great for overall engine efficiency, and it's definitely the first thing on our list for good reason. Tuning puts a lot of additional stress on the turbocharger. So once you're running a tune, the next thing that you're going to want to do is add some additional supporting modifications to help improve the efficiency of the turbocharger and reduce some stress on it. So the best thing to do that is going to be a 6.0 Powerstroke cold air intake. So here we've got our boosted performance 6.0 Powerstroke intake. This is going to be the second best modification that you can do after tuning the 6.0. With an intake, you're going to get around 8 to 12 wheel horsepower gains. And you're also going to get 1 to 2 miles per gallon of fuel efficiency gains, which makes this a great modification that ultimately pays for itself over time. Now, the most important thing about a cold air intake is it allows you to bring more air into the turbocharger. It increases the air density, which takes some stress off of the turbocharger, improves turbocharger efficiency, and is also going to give you faster turbo spool and better throttle response. This is our boosted performance intake here. It costs $299. It's one of the most affordable and highest quality intakes on the market, and so highly recommend one of these if you are looking at adding an intake and tuning to your 6.0. Now, after you've added a cold air intake, there's also another great airflow and intake related modification, and that's an upgraded intake horn or an intake elbow. We also have one here from Boosted Performance. This is only $100. It's not going to add a whole lot of horsepower. You might see around 5 wheel horsepower and 5 wheel torque gains from it, which aren't bad for a $100 product. But one of the biggest things that this will do is it will help lower your EGTs. You'll typically see around a 50 and in some cases even up to a 100 degree drop in EGTs. For $99, this is a great supporting modification that will help improve airflow, it'll improve turbo efficiency, it'll reduce your EGTs, and it'll provide some minor power gains as well. We recommend combining this with an intake for the additional benefits that you're going to get from a reliability and performance standpoint. So now, after we've made both our intake and intake elbow upgrades, we're bringing a lot more air into the engine, so we're going to want to get rid of that back pressure via an exhaust system. With more air coming in and the turbocharger running at higher boost levels, we're going to be creating more back pressure within the exhaust system. Back pressure acts as a negative force against the turbocharger, which puts additional stress on the turbo, decreases turbocharger reliability, and ultimately takes power away. We're going to want to go ahead and upgrade the exhaust system to reduce this back pressure and get a freer flowing exhaust, which is going to add power as well as reduce stress on the turbocharger, which helps improve the reliability of it. While you do get power gains from an exhaust system, you'll likely see around 5 to 15 horsepower depending on the setup that you go. One of the biggest benefits is the EGT reduction that you get from it. You'll typically see around 150 to 200 degree drop from an exhaust system. So this is another great supporting modification that you also get some good power gains out of as well. With the 6.0, it does have a catalytic converter or a diesel oxidation catalyst. So you do have a couple different routes that you can go. The best option is going to be going with a turbo back catless option, but due to emissions regulations, if you want to go the safer route, the best thing is going to be adding a downpipe and then combining a downpipe with a cat back portion of the exhaust system. Or you can get a full turbo back option that has a catalytic converter, but you can get one that is a high flow catalytic converter, which is a great option as well. So that covers it for our best 4 modifications. We've got tuning, a cold air intake, an intake elbow, and an exhaust system. Those are really the only things that you need to be able to get the 6.0 Powerstroke up to 450 wheel horsepower, and even potentially a little bit beyond it if you have the right supporting modifications. After tuning, it's important to bring more air in with an intake, with an intake elbow, and once you're doing that, it's important to get all of that air out with an exhaust system. Now that you've got all of these modifications, let's go ahead and talk a little bit about supporting modifications that you might want to consider if you're looking at modding your 6.0. So the first thing that we absolutely recommend that I mentioned at the beginning of this video is an oil cooler. If you want to go further on the bulletproofing side and do more bulletproofing upgrades, that's absolutely a great thing. But at a minimum, I'd recommend at least an oil cooler to fix a lot of the problems that that causes. Alongside that, another good supporting mod is head studs. The reason that head studs are recommended is because the 6.0 head is known to lift. But if you have an upgraded oil cooler, then it's not necessarily as important to fix this. The reason that the heads lift is because the oil cooler fails, which causes the EGR cooler to fail, which causes the engine to overheat, which causes the heads to lift. And so if we fix the oil cooler, then the EGR cooler becomes less of a problem. Engine temps are lower, and we're not gonna run into the issue with the heads lifting. ARP head studs aren't super expensive in themselves, but the labor to replace them is. This is a good idea, but it is expensive. So it's not necessarily required if you do have an upgraded oil cooler and if you aren't pushing tons of additional power. The next thing is going to be injectors. If you've got old factory injectors that are starting to go bad, then upgrading to 155cc injectors is a good idea, but it's definitely not recommended or required. Just that if you start pushing 425 or 450 wheel horsepower, you might run into an issue with those injectors not being able to keep up. And so you might want to look at injector upgrades if you're looking at pushing the limit of the factory injectors. And then the last thing is a lift pump. Again, this isn't required until about 500 wheel horsepower, but it certainly doesn't hurt to add one before, just for some added fueling and some added reliability out of the factory lift pump. Check out Boosted Performance, where you can buy our 6.0 intake as well as our intake horn. Anyways, guys, that covers it on all of our basic bolt-on modifications for the 6.0 Powerstroke. We are going to go ahead and do a video on bulletproofing as well as do a video on some of the more advanced modifications down the line. So if you appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for our future 6.0 Powerstroke upgrade videos. And